Oi, boy.
Four ballistic missiles have been launched towards Ukraine from the territory of Belarus.
The Russian military has begun a brutal assault on the people of Ukraine.
It was roughly 7 o'clock this morning when we heard the booms of the explosions here. Then over the next hour or so, at least 6 rounds of sirens rang out over this city.
Russian troops have reportedly taken full control of the area around the Chernobyl nuclear power station.
These troops you can see over here, they are Russian airborne forces. They have taken this airport.
Sure. Unfortunately, we have lost already 137 of our heroes, our citizens, including 10 officers. There are 316 injured.
Putin is the aggressor. Putin chose this war.
So it's like you wake up in a totally new reality at 5 a.m. and you find out that the world is no longer the safe place you imagined.
Rest.
I can't believe my eyes, I can't believe my ears, and it's a tragic, really tragic moment for Ukraine, for Russia as well.
Kyiv has this extremely deep underground transit system, and there's a lot of people who have been taking refuge there.
We've actually been very lucky to get out of Ukraine with the second to last train that was coming here. We've spent last 16 hours using all of our luck coming here.
We're in downtown Moscow and already protests against this invasion have begun. Hundreds of people out on the street, they've been chanting no to war. And we've been watching as one by one people are being arrested and taken away into trucks here. It takes a certain kind of bravery to protest in Putin's Russia, especially on the day he sends his country to war.
The message from everyone gathered here tonight is that this isn't just a Ukrainian problem, it is an international one.
Stop Russia now! Stop Russia now!
Please save our people! Another dozen of people, and maybe hundreds of people, might be murdered tonight.
We are totally not same as Russians, and we don't want to be a part of Russia or any other country.
It's really getting very emotional. And I cannot believe it's happening, really.
Well, let's take you live to Ukraine now. Bryce Wilson is an Australian photojournalist based there. Bryce, since you've woken up this morning, what are you seeing, hearing?
Honestly, seeing that footage was really upsetting for me, but this situation in Kyiv now, it's very bad. One of my friends just called me and told me that he's had to go and take his rifle, that tanks are getting closer to the outskirts of Kyiv, and he specifically said to me he wants me to take his wife and take her away from the war. So it's really crazy today. Like, I can't believe what is happening. Me and three colleagues, actually, we fled when Kramatorsk was attacked. Immediately after the war was declared, bombs started exploding outside my apartment. We have now fled to central Ukraine. We bought very, very bad cars with Bitcoin because there is no, you cannot get cash here. There is no working card services. And we're trying to push further west so that we can rally and keep reporting. My other two colleagues are going back to Donbas, which to me sounds like a really crazy idea.
It just sounds uncomprehensible. You were actually talking to the camera when a missile flew over your head. Let's quickly take a look.
It's crazy. I can't believe that Russia has declared war on Ukraine. That as soon as the declaration...
There you go.
Oh! That's a missile! That's a missile! That's a missile!
That was one of those, like,
holy.
How much physical danger are you actually in?
I don't know. I honestly don't know. Like, obviously, this is a dangerous and dynamic situation. And last night with my colleagues, we were staying up quite late trying to understand how the battle space was evolving. And like find a hole in the front line or the fighting areas around Western Ukraine that we can like know is safe, so we're not on the road near Russian military hardware. It's quite a stressful situation, and this is the first time I've been in an environment like this. I've worked in the front lines before, but when you're working in a very dynamic war environment, things can happen, and it's definitely very risky right now.
Bryce, you have been on the front lines, and there were a range of scenarios that could have unfolded. So are you surprised at the scale of what Putin's doing?
Yes, because even I said in some interviews, like to me, it seemed improbable that there would be this mass level invasion. Like I was just saying to my friend, I can't believe there are fighter jets fighting over Kyiv. There are bombs exploding in civilian houses. Like apartment buildings will have to be demolished because of the collateral damage from this artillery and stuff. So I can't fathom this. And like, I don't know if people back home even understand, like, this is a capital city of one of the like most beautiful parts of Europe, and it's being bombed. There are fighter jets in that area. There are tanks in that area. Planes are smashing into civilian buildings when they're shot out of the sky. Like this, even seeing the pictures on television, it does not do the chaos of it all justice. Like this, I honestly can't believe it. I'm somewhat lost for words.
Right, and there is chaos, but is there any evidence of Ukrainians putting up much of a fight, or are the Russians just coming in and taking what they want?
In my opinion, based on the data I'm seeing, there's a lot of like misinformation around the performance of the armed forces of Ukraine right now. A lot of it focusing, I guess it's negative, but based on stats that the Ministry of Defense released today, the Ukrainian armed forces in that area have destroyed hundreds of vehicles. They've killed something like 800 Russian soldiers, if the Ministry of Defense information is accurate. But inversely, something like 130 Ukrainian soldiers have been killed and over 300 wounded. So like already the war is brutal and catastrophic. And I fear that as they go into the urban environments, it will just get worse and worse. There'll be street to street fighting. And I think this sort of open plains warfare, especially with the javelins that the Ukrainian armed forces have, they have a benefit and an advantage at the moment. But tanks will lose that to an urban environment, and there will be just brutal street-to-street warfare.
Hey, Bryce, I'm sure your family is watching tonight, so I'm going to say what they and everyone else watching will say. That is, do try and stay safe if you can.
Yeah, I'm trying, doing my best. Appreciate it.
Thanks, Bryce. Well, Anna Davydenko is a Ukrainian citizen who has fled Kyiv and is sheltering in a nearby town. Anna, how are you doing now?
Hi, I'm okay. Slept for 3 hours, but so far in one piece.
So you're running on little sleep. You're obviously on the run and your country is being invaded. How does it feel to see this happen through your eyes? You're living it right now.
Yeah, we're living a nightmare. I still can't believe this is happening. I'm in complete shock. I learned about this yesterday morning. Yesterday, I woke up to this one text from my boyfriend who was in Kyiv with just one word, war. And I think it's the worst nightmare you can imagine happening, the worst thing you can ever wake up to.
And is your boyfriend safe? Is he okay?
Yeah, he's on his way to me right now. Hopefully he can get here soon.
Do you feel any safer, Anna, being where you are right now?
Yeah, I think this is one of the very few, if not the only region where there hasn't been missile attacks yet, and it's been quiet in this town so far.
Anna, with just a day's notice, you've fled, you've moved. What is your plan from this point onwards?
I'm currently waiting for some parts of people from my family to come and join me here. They have left Kyiv yesterday morning, but the rest of my family is still in Kyiv, and I just hope that I can help them get to safety here because I found a place in this little town.
In many respects, Anna, this is what was predicted. There was so much discussion about what Putin had planned. Why is it in reality so difficult to see, to experience, to comprehend?
because it doesn't make any logical sense. I also anticipated this to happen, and this is why a week ago I left Kyiv, where I'm from, and moved to this little town next to the western border, because I was so worried and because I thought that, yeah, there is a risk, but still I thought I was just being way too precautious, and now it's happening. We just can't believe it actually happened.
Anna, the West is talking a big game right now, saying that we stand by Ukraine, we're going to impose sanctions. But from where you're sitting, does it feel like the international community is supporting you or abandoning you?
I have mixed feelings about this. On one hand, I feel a lot of support and moral support. I think the economic sanctions that's been used can help in the long run, but I also feel like we need help right now, like today. Our army has been incredible yesterday. They're like still holding up, but how long will they stand? Will they stand through this day, through the next night? Like, we need something that can help us right now. We need military help. We need more stricter economic sanctions, something that can actually work and deter them.
Are you preparing yourself mentally to fight?
No. I'm not nearly like mentally stable enough to go through that. I'm sorry. But to be honest, yesterday after this all began, I realized I have never felt this amount of rage in my entire life. And if I saw an enemy soldiers, I don't know what I would do. It's just...
We are all thinking of you. Thanks for your time, Anna. Stay safe.
Thank you.